Hello, everybody. Jennifer Maker here. Have you seen the designs with photos in the letters and wondered how you could make your own? It's actually easier than you think. I have an older tutorial that shows you how to do this, but of course, things have changed, and so it's time for a fresh look. So in this video, I'll show you how to fill letters with images in Cricut Design Space and print them out for sublimation. You don't need any extra software. Then we'll put them onto these cute pillows, like this one, even some with sequins. So come with me to the craft table and we'll get started. You're going to be surprised at how easy it is to sublimate in Cricut Design Space. We'll use just a few of the design tools, then the print then cut feature, just a bit differently than normal, however. All you need to create your decoration is a photo and Cricut Design Space. You can learn the process using my examples and you can practice with my free files. Now I used my Sawgrass SG500 sublimation printer with compatible ink and paper, but you can also use a converted printer like this one. I have lots of information on sublimation printers over at jennifermaker.com/sublimation-for-beginners. Since we won't cut the design on a Cricut machine, you don't actually need to be hooked up to a Cricut for this technique. You just make sure you have one selected that has print then cut capability. I'm using a Cricut Maker 3 today as my selection, but I'm not actually cutting on it. Don't forget that. To transfer the design, you'll need some 125 gram 8.5 by 11 inch paper by A-Sub and butcher paper, heat resistant tape, scissors, a lint roller, a fan for ventilation, and of course a heat source. I'm going to use my Cricut Auto Press, but you can use another press that gets hot enough for sublimation with a pressing mat. I'll show you how to add the designs to a plain sublimation pillow color and one with sequins. Make sure you get the right size pillow insert to fit the cover too. It is so easy to fill letters with photos. You can combine this technique with other projects as well. You could make stickers, cards, t-shirts, mugs. There are so many possibilities here. Now let's learn how to fill letters with photos in Cricut Design Space. Step 1, get or prepare a design. If you want to get right to sublimating, there are 3 completed designs in the free download folder. To find them, go to jennifermaker.com/469 and look for libraries in the red bar at the top, and then either click get a password if you don't yet have one, or click enter the library. You can find the designs on the page by searching for design number 469 and then click it to download the zip file. There are some perfect pillow designs. Just upload the file that you want as a print then cut image and skip to resizing at the end of step 2. And if you're not sure how to do this, go to jennifermaker.com/svgs to learn how to unzip and upload files. I'll show you how to recreate the relaxed design so you can follow along with my photo from the folder or jump in with your own. Step 2, fill words with photos in Cricut Design Space. When you're ready to design, start with a blank canvas. Click text on the left and type relax or whatever word that you want to use. Click on the font menu to see your options. Since we want the image to be recognizable, options with thick, chunky, and consistent shapes will work better for this design. I'm going to use Impact, which comes with most computers, so look for it under your system fonts. And to figure out the font size, measure your pillowcase's width, or whatever you're going to put this on, right? You could, of course, put this on a t-shirt. We're just using a pillowcase. Mine is 16 inches, so I can use the maximum width of 9.25 inches that Cricut's print then cut feature allows. Back in Cricut Design Space, tighten up the word by clicking on letter space and entering negative 0.5 inches or whatever looks good to you. Make sure the lock icon is closed and then type 9 into the width field. That leaves space for an offset that we'll add at the end. Upload your photo as a complex print then cut image and add it to your canvas. I'll use the sunset photo. When you're picking a photo to go in your letters, start with easier things like landscapes.
If you want to incorporate pets or people, stick to just one or two faces so it's easier to line them up in the letters. Use the Arrange menu to select Send to Back so the image is behind the word. Keep the lock icon closed and resize the photo so the area that you want is covered by the word, and drag the word to fit as needed. To get a better idea of what parts of the photo will show, temporarily change the operation of your word to pen, which will outline it. And if you have a photo with people in it, place most of the face or faces under letters so they'll be in the final design. And just remember to change the operation back to print then cut when you're all finished. Now for the slicing. Select the word and the photo, just those two layers, and then click Slice. Delete the plain text and excess photo layers to reveal your letters filled with images. Now, I know those script or handwritten fonts are tempting, but here's an example with BFC flannel. The photo is much more recognizable with the impact, don't you think? You can certainly experiment with other fonts, just know that it takes some time to find the right font that works for your image. For some ideas, check out my font finder cheat sheets over at jennifermaker.com/cricutfontslist. To help the design stand out, I recommend you click Offset. You can use the sliding control or type in a number. I found that 0.125 worked well for my design. And then click Apply. Change the color of the outline if you'd like. I changed mine to a dark orange. Select the word Relax and its offset. And then, this is very important, click Flatten to complete the design. If you don't click Flatten, these will stay into separate layers and won't print out properly. So it's very important that when you do print then cut for your sublimation project that you always click Flatten. Step 3, print your sublimation design. Make sure the correct machine is selected and then click Make It in the upper right corner. On the Prepare screen, make sure your first mat says Print Then Cut and the material size fits your sublimation paper. My paper is 8.5 by 11 inches. And make sure the mirror toggle is turned on. And then click Continue. On the Make screen, click the Send to Printer button to prepare to print your design. Now before you print, make sure your paper is loaded correctly in your printer. Check your printer manual and paper packaging for help identifying the right side to print on and how to load it. Make sure your sublimation printer is listed here, and then, and this is very important, turn off Add Bleed and turn on Use System Dialog before you click that print button. You then want to print your design with the best paper and highest quality print settings with mirror off, since Cricut is already mirroring your image. If you don't know how to print from your sublimation printer, please go to jennifermaker.com/sublimationprintmethod and then let your print dry for a minute. For a normal print and cut project, we would put the printed image on a machine mat and use the Cricut to cut out the shape. But since we're sublimating the design, just trim the black registration marks away. It's that easy. Step 4, sublimate your design. Since we're heating sublimation dye, be sure to open a window and set up a fan to improve your ventilation. I'm going to use my Cricut Auto Press, but you can also use a traditional heat press or a Cricut Easy Press with a pressing mat. Set the temperature of your press to 385 degrees Fahrenheit and the time to 10 seconds. If you're using a different blank than I am for your pillow or whatever you're making, be sure to check the Cricut Heat Guide or your heat press's settings for the best temperature and time. You'll find the Cricut Heat Guide over at jennifermaker.com/easypress. Lint roll the pillow's front to remove any dust and debris. Place a clean sheet of white cardstock inside the pillow under the area that you're decorating. That will keep the ink from bleeding through. Put the cover on the pressing area so the zipper, which we'll put at the bottom of the pillow, is the closest to you. and make sure the zipper head is outside of the pressing area. Ideally, you'd want the zipper to be hanging off the mat so it doesn't cause any issues when you go to press it. When the press is all ready, preheat your pillowcase for 10 seconds. This smooths any wrinkles and removes moisture. I'm going to place my design in the center of the pillowcase, so I'll measure from the top and sides to find the middle. Of course, your pillow might be a different size, or maybe you want to place your design in a different location. So just find that spot and use heat-resistant tape to hold the sublimation print in place face down. Taping your print down is really important to prevent ghosting, which is a term that means blurriness and double images. Ghosting can happen if the sublimation paper slips as you open the heat press, and that's because the sublimation process is still in progress and the ink hasn't yet fully sublimated back down into a solid until it cools a bit. If the paper shifts, it can leave behind a shadow, making your design look blurry. So you don't want to skip this step. Be sure to tape. Cover the pillow with a clean sheet of white butcher paper and press at 385 degrees for 35 seconds. When the time is up, remove the butcher paper and let the design cool a bit so the dye can settle into the fabric. Then carefully remove the tape and the excess design paper. Did you know that you can sublimate on sequins? It's easy, it just takes a bit more heat and time. Set the temperature of your heat press to 400 degrees Fahrenheit and your time to 10 seconds, and push all the sequins so that only the white sides show. Then lint roll the cover well to remove anything that's loose, and check again that only the white sequins are showing. And then preheat your sequin pillow for 10 seconds. Put a sheet of white cardstock inside the pillow. Remember that the bottom with the zipper should be closest to you. Just like the other pillow, place the design face down where you want it. And then secure it with heat-resistant tape. Put clean butcher paper on top of the pillow and press it at 400 degrees for 55 seconds. When the time is up, remove the butcher paper. And when the pillow has cooled, carefully peel away the tape and see your awesome result. Once you put the insert inside and zipped up the pillow, you can hide and reveal the design by sweeping the sequins to either side. Isn't this awesome?
Aren't these pillows just adorable? I love how they turned out. And it's so nice to have my favorite photos nearby in a different way than just a photo frame, like our adorable cat Butterscotch. Sublimation designs become part of an item surface, so you don't really need to clean them any differently. For the plain pillow cover, I recommend you machine wash it in cold water and dry it on low heat. Now, sequins can't be machine washed, so hand wash the decorative pillowcase gently, then hang it to dry. If you need any help getting set up for sublimation, check out my Sublimation Startup mini course at jennifermaker.com/sublimationstartup. I walk you through the entire process of choosing and setting up your printer with the right ink, show you in more detail all of the tools that you can use and the variety of things that you can sublimate onto, and then show you how to use software to print and press beautiful sublimation projects. You can sign up right now and learn at your own pace. I also have a group just for sublimation crafting where you can get help and tips from other crafters who love to sublimate too. Come join us at jennifermaker.com/sublimationgroup to ask questions, share ideas, and get inspired. If you have any questions about how to do this technique, I would love to help you out. Just leave your question below this video or come ask in our sublimation group at jennifermaker.com/sublimationgroup. And that's it for today. Until next time, this is Jennifer Maker reminding you to craft a life you love.